friends. Chew on this nugget. Job 32 verse 8. But it is a spirit in a man, and the breath of the Almighty gives them understanding. It is the spirit in a man, and the breath of the Almighty gives them understanding. It is the spirit in a man. It is the spirit in a man. It is a spirit in a man, and the breath of the Almighty gives us understanding, gives them understanding. And the breath of the Almighty gives them understanding. It is the spirit in a man, and the breath of the Almighty, the breath of the Almighty gives him understanding, gives them understanding. The breath of the Almighty gives them understanding. It is a spirit in a man. It is a spirit, the spirit in a man. It is the spirit in a man, or it is the spirit in, it is a spirit in the man. And the breath of the Almighty, and the breath of the Almighty gives him understanding. And the breath of the Almighty gives him understanding. And the breath of the Almighty gives them understanding. It is the spirit in a man. You know, the spirit of man was created by the Lord, and it's eternal. It's the spirit of man is likened to the candlestick of the Lord. It's like the lamp of the Lord illuminating his inward parts. And it's here that he describes that it's that spirit that in a man, it's the breath of the Almighty that gives the man understanding. You know, when God speaks, God's words are spirit and they are life. And when he speaks from within us. We receive revelation. And he illumines our candlestick, if you will. And that candlestick releases that breath, comes, and it releases light within us. And understanding flows up into our mind like a river of life, like a river of light. You know, from the throne of God, there is a river of life. It's also a river of light because God is light. And in him, there's no darkness at all. So when he speaks, light comes out of him alone. Only light flows out of him. And when he speaks into us in our spirit, because our spirit is in union with the Spirit of God, when he speaks within our spirit, it illumines us. It makes us to see. It releases that river up within us. It's a river of understanding. And so we gain understanding from within. It's not we access and acquire things externally through our external senses. We actually come to know. By revelation. Revelation can be defined as knowing without having learned. You didn't learn it from a book. You didn't receive it from man, nor were you taught it. But you received it by revelation, by the breath of God within you that spoke into you and released understanding. You know, the Hebrew word for understanding is the word binah. And that can be described as a river. You know, the understand, binah is likened to a river. So when God speaks, when God opens his mouth and speaks to me, speaks to you, there's a river of understanding. River, his mouth is like a river. It's when he opens his mouth, it's like a river flows out of his mouth. It's also like a sword as well. But the river of God flows from within us. Jesus said, for from within, out of your innermost being shall flow a river of living water. That living water is also the living words of God, which are spirit and life, full of power and full of understanding, full of wisdom, pure revelation from him. And it gives us understanding. You know, we can be simple-minded people, and yet we can gain great understanding out of our place of intimacy with the Lord and allowing him to illuminate his candlestick within us. The lamp within us, and understanding to flow up within our spirit from within our innermost being and enlighten our eyes, brighten our minds, brighten us with perception and ability to see and to understand what we did not see nor understand prior to that, the entrance of light. This is the spirit of the Lord inside our spirit. But as it is a spirit in a man, and the breath of the Almighty that gives him understanding. And the breath of the Almighty, it is the breath of the Almighty inside of you and I that gives us understanding. So let's make sure that we're being inspired by him, that we're not receiving, if you will, bad breath. We don't want bad breath. We want the breath of the Almighty. We want the breath of light. We want the breath of the river of his life. Friends, chew on that.